in! Ha! Ha! Oh! Oh! Welcome to Short Story Time with Barnaby Buttersfield. I'm your host, Barnaby Buttersfield, and I'm here to show you the next book in our collection of tales that we shall read. Last time, we covered the Christmas story, Miracle of Jonathan Toomey. Good book. That was a good book. We all enjoyed. And now, we're going to move on. Did any of you read any of the previous books that I had shown you? Here, it's a new one. Lord Grizzly. It's about a bear. This book was written by Frederick Manfred. Fred Manfred. They didn't put any pictures in this book, so I guess we have to read this. Well, I know all I need to know now. In the back it says, hunter, trapper, resourceful fighter, and scout. Hugh Glass was just another rugged individual in a crowd of rugged men until he was mauled by a grizzly bear and left for dead. That's the end of the book. I spoiled the end of the book. I did not spoil the end of the book. There's more. But he was left for dead by his best friends. They never expected to see him again, but they did. And the man whose anger rose before them was not just Hugh Glass anymore. It was Lord Grizzly. Lord Grizzly. My summation of that synopsis is: a man gets possessed by a bear. The Chicago Sunday Tribune says this is a very fine, rich, bright novel. Above all, it is a novel deserving appreciative reading and warm applause. Of all those like the author valued the legends of America and believed in the perpetuation and the interpretation. Dallas should just Chicago Sunday Tribune. The first rate of fiction. In this story, there are three parts. Part one, the wrestle. Part two, the crawl. Part three, the showdown. The wrestle is about the time that the man wrestled the bear, and the bear won. The bear ate him. The bear ate him alive. But he survived. Even though he was ate alive, and he became possessed by the bear, and he crawled. That is what the crawl is all about. They have one picture in this whole book. The map. The map of the crawl. He crawled here. Here he crawled. Then the showdown. The showdown, which he fought his friends. And he took his grizzly hands, because now he's a grizzly. He's possessed by the grizzly. He took his grizzly hands, and he mauled his friends to death. That is my submission of Lord Grizzly by Frederick Manfred. You should enjoy this book. Pick it up at your local book bearing. Now, here are a few more that you might want to pick up and enjoy. The first is The Merry Adventures of Robin Hood. Many people know the story of Robin Hood. He was a merry little fox who lived in the woods and followed a bear around. More bears! Bears. There are illustrations of doe. Men walking. Men being wowed by the power of the windmill. There's even a picture of a man leading another man. We don't see this enough in today's society. That's how I was led by a man. I was led places I do not wish to recall. Read the next in our series that you should pick up and read if you get a chance is Slavery in Politics in the Early American Republic. This is talking about a long-time tradition for Americans to own things, and slaves was one of them. Slavery. Don't do it. Slavery and American politics were two things that conflicted at the time. Because slaves could not politic. And because of that, things didn't go well. There was walls. Look, there were beatings. That is not my family. Don't read this. Thank you for joining us. Short story time with Barnaby Buttersfield. I am Barnaby Buttersfield, and I've been your show this evening, current day, and you should stay tuned for more.